Hello there, welcome back to the Ogre. Well, I wondered where I was there for a minute. The Ogre reacts, reminisces and other things, reviews, yes. Somebody wake me up, give us a poke with a pointy stick, will you? Anyway, right, today, a while back I downloaded a couple of EPs, I suppose they were, from a band called Vida. I've not forgotten about the music because I listen to it fairly regularly, but I had forgotten about the artiste and what they said on their little stitherum on Bandcamp. I listened to this the other day. I bought this, so it must be reasonable. In fact, it's very good. However, it is different to Vida. It's the same artist. That's the point I'm trying to make. It's very different to Vida. Those of you who've heard of Vida will know this. If you're interested enough, go and find that part of that project after this, if you so wish. Anyway, the things about this I want to talk about, but let's listen to a bit first. So I waited, normally I wait about a minute and then make a comment, but I knew, because I've heard this two or three times now since I bought it, that there's going to be a change in emphasis. So the beginning of this song, if I'd heard it on its own, I would probably skip the whole album on the strength of just that opening minute or so. But I'm the sort of person that is now well aware that if you let things linger a bit and listen a bit longer, you will probably have your mind changed very often, and that was the case with this. The thing that intrigued me most about this album has yet to manifest itself, so I'm going to leave that until it does. But nonetheless, that sort of post-Blackie intro, if you will, has now fell firmly into atmospheric black metal territory, if we want to put labels on things. And so I'm in a place of deep contentment now. So let's see how far we go with that. Okay, that is the point I've been waiting for, or the part I've been waiting for, to make a general comment on the album. So there, that sweet female vocalisation makes me happy. elsewhere on the album, it has me stroking my chin a bit, because I think it needs... On other tracks, it's more operatic. I always struggle with those sort of vocals in any genre. Operatic vocals just by and large, just turned me about face and marched me out the door. On the songs on this album where that is the case, I'm starting to come round a little bit. Holding my nose on a couple of occasions, by and large, I'm being swayed. But this particular song, I have no problem at all with the female vocals. They are a perfect contrast to the more aggressiveness of the guitar et al. And of course to the growly vocals the artist provides, presumably himself. So it is interesting the different intensities of the female vocals on here and how they affect me personally. Not that I am in any way aggrieved. Let's make that clear. So just before the female vocals kicked in there, I mean, Le Prochain Hiver, probably slaughtered that, but forgive me if I have, which I probably have. I presume are French. It's a French label that they're on, and the music just before the female vocals kicked in. If I was doing my geo guessing, I would say that's French. That's a French artist, without a doubt. There's something oozing French culture with that section, even though of course it was still metallic. So yeah, if I was keeping count, then I would have given myself another tick there for other than the obviousness of the name, maybe. But the music itself at that point, France, it's France. But anyway, I quite like the. Going back to the female vocals again, that sort of dichotomy of slowly sung sweet female vocalisation over fairly rapid music always works well for me, in the same way that synths do, droning slowly over rapid music.
Thank you.
can't remember if there's a dash to the end. If there is, I'm going to stop now and just mention a couple of things. Something about that, again, that refrain there that reminds me of a 1970s French crime drama, for some reason. Throughout the album, there are forays into folky or cultural non-metallic sort of music, which accompany the fury and the franticness, and they work very, very well. The violin is quite prominent in on some songs, and I've discussed recently how effective that can be as a counterpoint to aggressive music. And although I've mentioned this being atmospheric black metal, there is quite an abrasiveness to the guitar and a fair bit of echo, which on some atmospheric black metal tends to get smoothed off a little bit. But not here, not on this song. So there you go. That is, thinking about it, one of the more straightforward songs on the album, yet it's still full of drama. I can safely say, as far as recommendations go, if you like songs full of moment and switches and changes, this album's for you, because it does. There's a lot of variety amongst the surge, and you know, even those vocals parts, I mean, the female vocals, by and large, I quite like, and in some sections, like a lot, like on parts of this. But even those ones where for fairly short passages that they grate on me still, they're still compelling. In fact, the sort of thing that a bit like a car crash, really, you can't avoid looking at it, even though you know you shouldn't. And it's the same with those, the most operatic vocals on here. I listen to them, no, and I don't particularly like them, but still feel compelled enough to listen. Not sure if that's a masochism thing or not, but I enjoy this album in its entirety, regardless of the couple of bits that, as I say, I'm having to stroke my chin over. But there you go. Just pondering on the how many albums featured dying or dead deer, stags. It seems to be a recurrent theme. If it's the same stag, then I feel very sorry for it. Anyway, clicky bollocks. Catch you all next time. Cheerio.